tryouts are today. I want to be ready.
Lock down that point guard spot.
There's no point guards in field hockey, Dad.
Field hockey?
My name is Andre Johnson. I have a great career, a spectacular house, and a loving family I'm surrounded by every day.
Hey, Pops.
Son, can I just please get a little coffee in me before you start this morning?
But as a black man with all this success, sometimes I feel like an oddity.
If you look to your left, you'll see the mythical and majestic black family.
Lately, I feel in order to make it, we've all dropped a little of our culture.
What's up, Andy?
Sup?
Andy? That's not even close to Andre.
I think it says I'm edgy but approachable.
I think it says I hate my father and I play field hockey.
You think I'm overreacting, babe?
Why would I think you would overreact?
Maybe you're right, babe.
I love you.
I love you too.
No.
Dad, I want to have a bar mitzvah. And I'll get a Hebrew name. I'm going to go with either Shlomo or Shmuel.
We're doing a bang-up job over here.
Listen up. I'm going to need my family to be black. Not black-ish.
Daddy's scaring me.
Why don't we take a black break and go get some white yogurt?
Yeah!
Hey, hold on. Hold on. Slow your roll, you two. Junior, when you turn 13, I'm throwing you an African rites of passage ceremony. Stand right there and experience your roots.
You better off watching Roots.
Uh-oh.
It's not that big of a deal.
All this coming from a mixed woman who technically isn't even really black?
If I'm not really black, then could somebody please tell my hair and my ass? This is what you always wanted.
To successfully raise our family in a better situation than we had.
I really screwed this up, didn't I?
Screwing things up's just another part of what it means to be a father. It's how you learn to fix things.
If that boy wants a bar mitzvah, I'm gonna throw that boy a bar mitzvah.
Ladies and gentlemen, Andre Jr.'s hip-hop bro mitzvah.
Be damned if I'm calling him Andy, though.
From executive producers Anthony Anderson and Lawrence Fishburne. Black. Ish.
Oh my God.
It's important for you to hold on to your culture.
Honestly, the only thing I'm really trying to hold on to right now is my first boob.
You can't be mad at him for that.
Okay, so when I saw the preview, I thought it treated race differently than other shows do. Usually they don't bring up, like, the racial stereotypes, like, explicitly in the show. But in this one, they're, like, saying that people felt they didn't feel like they belonged to... They didn't feel like who they were belonged to what their race was. So I think it's a little different than most shows are that are about race.
When you compare this TV show to other shows like Modern Family, Modern Family employs stereotypes of each race and uses that to gain viewers and popularity. But this show kind of looks at the stereotypes and then challenges them while still kind of expressing them through specific characters like the dad.
When the show is all about race, it made me feel uncomfortable because I'm not used to shows bringing out these taboo topics in society, and it really opened my eyes. It showed me how much I throw it under the rug and I don't think about how racist I am subconsciously. I think the Cosby Show made the black American family very average. It didn't make him seem like an anomaly or an exotic family to look at, whereas this new show is making a black family like, oh, look at them, they're in their natural habitat. And I don't really like how they're they're bringing race into the subject. Like, that's, that doesn't matter when it comes to a family.
I thought in both the Cosby Show and this new show, the black families are like successful black parents in their careers. And although both shows show they're both successful, in the new show it portrays it differently than it did in the Cosby Show.
This show depicts being black as expressing all of the stereotypes that are known by society, and Black-ish is only expressing a couple of them. Like, the son said he was going to play hockey when the dad wanted him to play basketball because basketball's a black sport and hockey's a white sport. So the son is Black-ish while the father's trying to be entirely black.
Yeah, I feel the same way. The black is when people identify with like a certain set of stereotypes that are expected of black people, but Black-ish is when they do things that are both black and white stereotypes, so they feel like they don't belong to either one completely, so they describe themselves as Black-ish.
I think that Black-ish is also there's a stigma that comes along with black, and if you're Black-ish, you're a little bit better than black people. Like, being closer to white is what you want to be when you're black, so that you're more respected and you're seen as better in society. I think that the show playing on that is just hurting the stigma even more and making it worse for people who want to be black and not black-ish.
Since Obama's been elected, I don't think race has changed, or that the amount of race depicted in the media has changed. I think it's always been an issue all throughout the 20th century, and since he started coming on the radar around 2007, I don't think it's changed much, and it's still going to be the same level throughout the future.
I think that it has changed, because around the election time, there was a lot of talk about, I'm voting for the black guy, or I'm voting for the white guy. But before that, there was no talking like, I'm voting for the white guy, are you voting for the other white guy? Because that was not a thing. But since his election, and since the time he was discovered, there has been more talk about it in the media, so that it has had more presence.
I think that there have been slightly more predominantly ethnic figures in TV shows now, where they're very blackish presidents or blackish male household owners or blackish people in power, and it's just playing off of Obama's presidency. And I don't think much more than that has changed.
So attributes I associate with successful people are hardworking, trustworthy people who are able to understand people, have a lot of empathy, and I think that really helps them do what they need to do. And I don't associate these with any particular race. I think it can apply equally to white and black people.
Successful qualities are, in my opinion, are leadership-like qualities. So somebody who's good at communication, someone who's outgoing, influential, they like are the powerful person in the room. They have good teamwork skills, but they always like are leading the team. And I don't know if it's race specific, but when I do think of a good leader, it would traditionally be a white person based on media. So.
I don't think the American dream is racist per se. I think that there have been so many roadblocks for blacks to achieve the American dream that when you think of it, you only think of white men who have achieved the American dream. If society wasn't so racist, I think both blacks and whites could achieve the American dream.
I think the American dream is racist. I think a lot of the goals in the American dream are specific to white culture, like living in a white picket fence with children and taking them to soccer practice every day. I feel like that has more to do with white, like a white lifestyle. more so than a Black lifestyle.
While the intentions of the American Dream isn't to be racist, I think that it ends up being racist. Like he said, it is basically a lot of white stereotypes shoved into an ideal that it's hard for some people to achieve, because traditionally speaking, Black families come from lower economic statuses, and it's harder for them to reach what the American Dream is for white people. So it does end up being racist.
I do think when Blacks reach the American Dream, they have to assimilate into white culture, because the American Dream itself is inherently based on white ideals. So in order to reach that status, they have to change them. If they're originally identified Black culture, they have to change themselves in order to fit into the white culture that is associated with the American Dream.
I think that Blacks can only reach a certain level in society, and after that you have to take on white ideals. For example, Tyler Perry could only be so successful, but he capitalizes on Black ideals and Black stereotypes to make others laugh. And the show is doing the same. They're capitalizing on the idea of Blacks not being as good as whites in society, and they want to act like that they can bring out their Blackness instead of being Blackish.
I think that when Black families reach the American Dream, they end up compromising their Blackness, because like the TV show in the preview for it, it showed how the father identifies as a Black man, and then the rest of his family ends up being Blackish because of the position they have in society. He never raised them to be Blackish. He wanted them to be raised Black, but they ended up assimilating into the culture around them, and then they were raised Blackish, so they compromised their Black ideals to fit into the American Dream.
Blackish is talking about race more than they're talking about culture, even though they want to state that culture is more important than race within the society that we live in today. But America is a melting pot, so therefore there are still major parts of our society that are defined by race. So the American Dream in a capitalist society is all about wealth and family, but within Blackish, they focus on race more than they focus on his success. And even when he gets promoted, it still has to deal with the fact that he's Black, so he gets put in the urban division. So with him having this problem, he's still focusing on the white ideals that America has, which are important, but also we need to talk about how Dre loses the fact that he got a promotion to the fact that people within his job are focusing on his race. At least that's what he thinks, but his boss then says, would you rather have a white person run the urban division rather than a Black person? So there's a whole bunch of different conflict that's going on with that. But then in the United States, we are a melting pot, but we are changing to focus more on the diversity within our country and trying to see how different races fit in. But the American Dream tries to fit into all races, but what Blackish is doing is they're trying to overcompensate and exploit the Black stereotype within a virtually non-existent society since this Cosby Show. So there's a whole bunch of different problems that Blackish brings up, and it's not, although it is very popular in TV, it's not demonstrating Blackness in America the way it should be.